Hi, and welcome to Castanet's Week in Review. I'm Nick Johansson with your top stories from this past week. The coronavirus that stemmed from the Chinese city of Wuhan continued to spread rapidly this week, at last count infecting more than 1,200 people and killing more than 40. Wuhan, with a population of 11 million, has been effectively shut down, with limited outbound travel allowed from the city. Starting on Sunday, private car use was banned in the downtown area. The U.S. reported its first infection Tuesday, a man in Washington state who had recently returned from the Wuhan area. The man is being treated in Everett Hospital. A case has since been reported in Chicago, along with multiple infections in Australia, Malaysia, France, and Japan. A former Mount Bushiri secondary teacher convicted of sleeping with a student multiple times over a 13-month period apologized in court Thursday during a sentencing hearing. Bradley Furman has pleaded guilty to 12 charges, including sexual exploitation of a 17-year-old student, and 9 counts of breaching his bail conditions after he continued to sleep with the teen after he had been initially charged. The Crown is seeking close to a 6-year jail sentence for Furman, while on Thursday, Furman's defense counsel argued 3 years is more appropriate. His sentence will be delivered on February 11th. This is the first winter that AIM Roads has taken over the highway maintenance from the Shuswap to the South Okanagan, and they've faced public criticism for their efforts so far. On Thursday, Castanet learned that the company has been written up by the Ministry of Transportation and Infrastructure 7 times since October. The non-conformance reports are issued when contractors are not meeting ministry expectations, but the ministry did not provide details about what they were issued for. The ministry noted it has been a particularly bad winter so far, with significantly higher than average snowfall. Due to Vernon's McKay Water Reservoir nearing capacity this week, the treated water was rerouted into Okanagan Lake. The water in the reservoir is usually used to irrigate parks and golf courses, but recent weather conditions have caused increasing water levels in the reservoir. A local environmental group is urging the city to find a different solution, saying the reclaimed water can still contain pharmaceuticals, endocrine disruptors, and other chemicals, but the city disagrees.
And once they go through the process and see how comprehensive and complex it is, and the water that is produced at the end of it, I think we can change people's minds.
After a lack of participating teams led to the cancellation of the Canucks Young Stars Classic in Penticton last year, the popular event featuring NHL prospects will be back next summer. Tuesday, the Canucks announced they will return to the South Okanagan Event Center from September 11th to 15th, with prospects from the Calgary Flames, Edmonton Oilers, Winnipeg Jets, and the Vancouver Canucks. That's it for this week's Week in Review. For Castanet News, I'm Nick Johansson.